and welcome to Fact or Fiction, a show where we discuss what made the news this week and whether it was real or not. I'm Suyash Barvain. With me is Jensi Jacob from Boom. Hi, Jensi.
Hi, Suyash.
All right, for our first story, we've got a familiar subject of fakery, the Indian Armed Forces. Now, the heroism and the achievements of the armed forces, without any exaggeration, are already remarkable. But despite having the facts already in their favor, the fake news brigade seems to love making things up about our soldiers. Jensi, what's the latest overly patriotic work of fiction?
So, Suyash, let me just say this. There are many fake news that we bust, images that are malicious in nature. This one is not that, probably out of sentiment, love for the army and the soldiers. So, let me give you that caveat right at the beginning. So, this is BJP MP Kiran Kher. She's put out this image. Probably this came on December 16th due to Vijay Divas, celebration of Vijay Divas. That day, this image originated on Twitter. And she, this image, when you see it, you can see two soldiers in trenches, extreme snow conditions. And she mentioned saying that this is the Siachen Glacier and talked about how, our Indian soldiers are really, roughing it out so that we are safe. Now, that's the sentiment. Also, actress Shraddha Kapoor, she also shared this. Another very senior former and a retired army officer, he also shared it, who has a verified handle. Now, the import of all this is that how these are Indian soldiers. We went and fact-checked this image and we found that way back in 2012, this image first came on Twitter and on internet as well. Some people have called it out fake earlier, where they said that these were Ukrainian soldiers. No, they are not even Ukrainian soldiers. The only something which is more credible that we got, whether these soldiers were Russian soldiers, and there are a lot of references that have been given to this. So yes, this is not a malicious image. We called her out and we also pointed it out to her. But as usual, they decided not to delete it.
So this is actually an image that has been busted before, several times. So that one's fake. But an important aside before we move on. Often people will say to me, yeah, so what if the image is fake? The sentiment is good. No, that's not how this works. You can't be okay with lies or fakery just because it's for a good cause.
Right.
Fake news is fake news. It doesn't matter if its heart is in the right place. This story is 100% false. For our next story, we herald the return of one of our favorite fakers, Shankhnad. Jensi, we've had a few run-ins with this Twitter handle. We're very familiar with him. And this time, he's gone after very familiar territory. The classic fake news format of cow violence. Now, the video we're about to show you is graphic and could be very disturbing, but here it is. Suddenly disturbing footage there, Jensi. What's the story with this?
So this is a cow which you can see in the video. Very disturbing because something has happened. It looks very clear. We don't know how it happened, but by looking at the video in itself. But you can see that the jaw is not there and it's bleeding. And someone
it's
is
like a very, very grievous injury.
Yes, very grievous injury. Now, Shankhnad, who loves to propagate these kind of rumors and also bring about all this communal angle of Muslim, Hindu and all that. He has propagated the story saying, look at how many, look at what has happened here. Some local Muslims have fed a bomb to this cow and that's how it exploded. And that's how this happened. Now, a lot of us actually asked, the Madhya Pradesh police, because this is where he claimed it happened. And the Madhya Pradesh Home Minister himself, Bhupendra Singh, he came on Twitter and he said no, this has no communal angle to this. In fact, what he says is that these were some local Adivasis who had actually put up this this local explosive to catch wild boars.
Yes.
And that's something that they do there, and accidentally this cow happened to bite into it, and that's how this happened. Now, all this does not matter to Shankhnad at the end of the day, because what he believes is what he believes.
Right, he kind of doubled down on it.
He, instead of probably deleting it and saying that this is the right context to it, he decides not to believe the Home Minister himself, who probably in a very rare case, you see him coming out and says, no, this is some local conspiracy where the cops have tied up with the local Muslims and has decided to go after this. He refuses to believe the story. And the video, you see how many times it has been seen, the number of retweets. But at the end of the day,
It's pretty startling. But let's talk about the power of one fake Twitter handle, right? This power of one Twitter handle that constantly spreads fake news. The Home Minister has to come out and tweet a clarification. And even then, there's the classic conspiracy theory pivot, oh, they're all lying to you.
Right.
Isn't it time Twitter took some kind of action?
Yes, you know, I'm really surprised. And if Twitter is any of your officials are seeing this show, you know, how many times have we pointed out to you about Shankhnath? You know, this is, I mean, if you want, we will give you evidence for it. Again and again and again, he's creating, you know, a communal situation where, you know, he calls out Muslims in cases where there is no involvement of any religion. And despite that, Twitter gives him people like him a platform so that, you know, he acts, you know, he very actively manages to create a fight and create this kind of a situation.
Right. This story and much of what Shankhnath tweets is malicious, communal, but also 100% fake. Now, a story that recently went hugely viral seems to show footage from a news channel called Only News 24/7. By the way, I've never heard of these guys. I don't know who they are. No idea. Anyway, it seems to show a group of people chanting slogans that are distinctly un-Indian. Now, this video even asks people to share it extensively on WhatsApp until it reaches Prime Minister Modi.
Right.
Chelsea, what's happening here?
So, you know, you could see the anchor claiming it to be from an Indian teacher, Indian private teacher, a private school teacher, and also the viewer you can hear saying that share this so that it reaches up to Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Otherwise, if you don't do this enough, you'll hear these kind of Pakistan Zindabad, you know, slogans everywhere in the country.
Yeah, that logic makes zero sense.
Yeah, that makes complete zero sense.
Zero sense.
And when we trace this video back, obviously, you know, at one look, we could figure out that this is from Pakistan. It seems to be some cricket rivalry, and proved to be right also, because we could trace this back to a Facebook page by a lady called Nadia Khattak. Now, we don't know whether that's her account, but we could you know, make out that by looking at the images and also searching for news stories, that she is in fact from Imran Khan's party in Pakistan.
Oh, so she's like a known political face.
She's a known political face. And this video was also shot somewhere on June 18th or around that time, when India had lost to Pakistan in Champions Trophy final. You know? If you want me to be patriotic, one of those rare occasions when India lost to Pakistan. But at the end of the day, let me disappoint all those who want to believe such slogans are, you know, par for the course in India by a certain community. No, let me disappoint you. This is not from India, but this is from Pakistan.
Right. So a video from Pakistan featuring a known political face from Pakistan. Only News 24/7. Shame on you and your fact check team. This story is 100% false. Now, we know Shashi Tharoor uses grandiose vocabulary in his many Twitter contretemps. Sorry, Jensi, I had to do it. But does he also share fake news? Oh, the horror of it all. Jensi, what the farrago is going on?
So, you know, Shashi Tharoor, despite, you know, all the credibility that he has and, you know, the beautiful language that he uses.
Yes.
You know, he's a delight, actually, on Twitter, you know, at the end of the day.
In a world of bad grammar and no punctuation, Shashi Tharoor really is.
Also, he has a great sense of humor. Yes. I don't know where is, or probably does he intend for us to have a sense of humor in this
about
painting.
These things.
But clearly, you know, what is fake, and we need to call out people for that. Now, if you see this image, you have Swapna Augustine. She's a very famous artist. She doesn't have arms, and she, you know, very beautifully paints with her feet. And she's got a lot of, you know, a lot many people have written about her in the past, and her paintings are actually very beautiful.
Very well known, and so is her work.
Yes, and she doesn't need to be tagged along with a work which is not hers, you know. And what you see on the other side is an optical illusion painting. And now, this is by a Ukrainian artist called Oleg Shupliak. And now, he, you know, when you search for this, it was very easy for Shashi Tharoor to search for this.
Again,
you know?
Another famous painter with very famous works.
Right. And when you look at it, his paintings are all like this, you know, where you have some very beautiful nature along with a face to it, and you really need to look for it and you need to appreciate
the
beauty.
Captivating,
you know, very captivating.
Work,
Now, many people actually called out Shashi Tharoor for this and said, you know, gave him a link. We also gave him a link, right? And we said that this is not her painting. But, you know, Shashi Tharoor, you disappoint us. We thought you are different. But at the end of the day, that painting and that tweet is still there on his Twitter feed.
All right, we're not art buffs. We don't know much about art, but we do know how to Google things.
Right.
That tweet is false. That wraps it up for this week. A very Merry Christmas from the team here at Boom Live to all of you. But before we go, here at Boom Live, our mission is very simple. We want to bust fake news. So we're going where fake news lives and thrives, on your WhatsApp. You can subscribe to our Boom Live broadcast by WhatsApping us on this number. Our sincere hope is that we bust a fake news story before it even reaches you. You can also use that number to WhatsApp us a story that looks dubious or you think might be fake, so we can tell you whether it's fact or fiction. All right, you can find more fact checks on boomlife.in. You can follow us here and here. Thanks so much for joining us. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.